Hello everyone. In this lecture, we are going to discuss DMSO based reagent, means oxidizing agent having DMSO, dimethyl sulfoxide. These four DMSO based reagent we have to discuss in this lecture. One is Swern oxidation, second is Corey-Keim oxidation, third is Pfitzner-Moffat oxidation, and fourth is Oppenheimer oxidation. All these are the DMSO, dimethyl sulfoxide based reagents. Let us start with this Swern oxidation. This application of Swern oxidation is to convert primary alcohol to aldehyde and secondary alcohol to ketone. The reagent in Swern oxidation is dimethyl sulfoxide in oxalyl chloride. Oxalyl chloride is the derivative of oxalic acid, chlorine derivative of oxalic acid, followed by treatment with triethylamine as a base. The primary alcohol is converted to aldehyde, and obviously secondary alcohol will oxidize to ketone. These are the some applications are mentioned here. Here this is a CH2OH group, that is primary alcoholic group. On treatment with DMSO, oxalyl chloride in triethylamine, we get primary alcohol is oxidized to aldehyde. Here it is secondary alcohol, the secondary alcohol is oxidized to ketone. Here it is primary alcohol is oxidized to aldehyde. Here it is primary alcohol, it is oxidized to aldehyde. And beauty of this reagent is that carbon-carbon double bond is not affected, it is remains as it is. See this one, it is the heterocyclic compound furan. Furan ring remains as it is, carbon-carbon double bond remains as it is. These are unaffected, only CH2OH group, that is primary alcohol group, is oxidized to aldehyde. Interesting to see its mechanism. Mechanism of Swern oxidation. See, this is step one, it is dimethyl sulfoxide. As oxygen is more electronegative than sulfur, these 500 electrons are open on the oxygen. So oxygen have the excess electron, so negative charge is written over there, and sulfur is deficient. Okay, so we can say these are the resonating structures of dimethyl sulfoxide. Now, being electron rich, this oxide ion will attack on the carbonyl carbon. Okay, when this bond is formed between carbon and oxygen, this pi bond is open on oxygen. Carbon oxygen double bond is there, pi bonded electrons will open on the oxygen, and oxygen will have the negative charge. So formation of negative bond and pi bond is opening on open on oxygen takes place simultaneously. When this oxide ion is formed, obviously oxide ion is unstable and it will try to stabilize itself. So now that negative charge, these two electrons are retained back, again bond will form there, and when this new bond is formed between carbon and oxygen again, at the same time this carbon chlorine bond cleavage takes place. So there is a removal of Cl negative, that is chloride ion. So it is shown in first in single step, that formation of new bond, opening of this pi bonded electron, then retain back of these two electrons and removal of chloride ion is shown in the single step here. And after this, after removal of chloride ion, we get this moiety. Then this chloride ion attack on this sulfur from backside. It is just a nucleophilic backside attack. When this new bond is formed between sulfur and chlorine, in between chloride ion and sulfur, this bond will break. This detachment of this bond will take place, sulfur oxygen bond. When this new bond is formed between oxygen and carbon, this pi bond will open on oxygen. Oxygen will bear the negative charge, and it is unstable after bearing negative charge. Then this negative charge will be retained back. There is a formation of and the breaking of this bond takes place. When this bond is break here, means this bonded pair of electrons are shifted here, carbon oxygen triple bond is formed, that is carbon monoxide, and chloride ion leaves the moiety. So see the byproduct, this one is the byproduct, carbon dioxide gas, it is carbon monoxide gas, this is chloride, Cl negative, leaves the moiety, and a new bond is formed between sulfur and chlorine, and we get this moiety. This is the first step. In the second step, the nucleophilic attack. Now this is our secondary alcohol. We may take here primary alcohol. This secondary alcohol, nucleophilic attack on the sulfur, SN2 type. The bond formation between sulfur and oxygen takes place. At the same time, leaving group, chloride, lose the moiety. The bond is formed between sulfur and oxygen here. And at the same time, sulfur-chlorine bond cleavage takes place. So this is bond formation. Obviously, as oxygen donates its lone pair, it is a coordinate bond. And as oxygen donates lone pair, it have the positive charge. Now it is electron deficient. In the next step, this chloride ion, which is eliminated from this step, now it acts as a base and it abstracts this proton. Oxygen is electron deficient. After donation of this proton, it will become stable. So this bonded pair of electron between oxygen and hydrogen will shift on the oxygen. Oxygen will gain its lone pair. Now this H positive and this Cl negative, there is a loss of HCl, and we get this one. Okay. And now last step. As I told you, that triethylamine in the next step, it acts as a base. It is a base. It abstracts this proton from the methyl group. Two methyl groups are there attached to the sulfur. So one proton is abstracted by the triethylamine from this methyl group. Now after abstraction, after removal of this H positive, what will be the charge on the carbon? Negative. So carbanion formation takes place. This is the carbanion. Now this CT3N triethylamine and this H positive nitrogen-hydrogen bond will form, and nitrogen loses its lone pair, so that's why nitrogen have the positive charge. It is removed. Okay, so after detachment of carbon-hydrogen bond, carbon have the negative charge, carbanion is formed. In the next step, intramolecular proton transfer takes place. This proton from this carbon migrate to the oxygen, and here CH3, TH2 negative and H positive, CH3 is formed again. It is CH3, it is another CH3. Instead of R and R dash, please read it as a CH3, and this is also CH3. And when this carbon-hydrogen bond detachment takes place, this bonded pair of electrons are shifted here. The new bond is formed between carbon and oxygen. And when this new bond is formed, at the same time, there is a detachment of this oxygen-sulfur bond over the sulfur. And in this way, we get this moiety, CH3, C double bond O, that is ketone. In this way, the secondary alcohol is converted to ketone. If we take the example of primary alcohol, we will get the aldehyde. And the byproduct is this dimethyl sulfur. This is the mechanism of Swern oxidation. Okay, what is Swern oxidation? It is a sensitive reagent which oxidizes primary alcohol to aldehyde and secondary alcohol to ketone. Okay, now the second reagent that we have to discuss is Korey-Kim oxidation. For the Korey-Kim oxidation, the reagent is dimethyl sulfide, N-chlorosuccinamide and triethylamine as a base. DMS, it is the abbreviation of dimethyl sulfide. NCS, it is the abbreviation of our N-chlorosuccinamide, and ET3N, it is the triethylamine. The function is same as that of Swern oxidation. Primary alcohol is oxidized to aldehyde, secondary alcohol is oxidized to ketone. And mechanism is also somewhat same. Let us have a look. This is the mechanism of Swern, this oxidation, where this is a N-chlorosuccinamide, it is dimethyl sulfide. In the first step, what happens, see, there is this chlorine and nitrogen bond cleavage takes place. This nitrogen gain its bonded pair of electron from this NCl bond, and that's why bears negative charge. And this Cl is now in the form of chloronium ion, Cl positive. So sulfur donates its lone pair to the chloronium ion, and the bond is formed between sulfur and chlorine, and that's why sulfur bears the positive charge. In this way, there is a formation of dimethyl sulfonium chloride salt, chloride ion we can say. After the formation of this, you can see here the same reagent, intermediate is formed in this one oxidation also. After formation of this intermediate, this step is same as that of Swern oxidation. Okay, so in Corycium oxidation also, the second step is same, only there is a difference of first step. Okay, this step is same as that of the Swern oxidation. Let us see the applications of this oxidation. Here you can see the primary alcohol, as I told you, is oxidized to aldehyde. Secondary alcohol is oxidized to ketone. Primary alcohol is oxidized to aldehyde without affecting this tetrahydrofuran, that is heterocyclic ring. Carbon-carbon double bond is also not affected. Here also carbon-carbon double bond is not affected. Primary alcohol is oxidized to aldehyde only. Here also the primary alcoholic group is oxidized to aldehyde. Okay. Then third reagent, DMSO base reagent, that is Pitzner-Moffat oxidation. It is also DMSO base reagent. It is the combination of dimethyl sulfoxide with DCC, that is dicyclohexyl carbodiimide. We know the role of DCC. DCC is the dehydrating agent. The combination of dehydrating agent with dimethyl sulfoxide in acidic condition, again the function is same. Primary alcohol is oxidized to aldehyde and secondary alcohol is oxidized to ketone. See the mechanism of this oxidation, Pitzner-Moffat oxidation. This is our dicyclohexyl carbodiamide, that is DCC. As I told you, it is the reaction takes place in acidic media. So this proton is there. This proton attack on the lone pair of nitrogen, and a bond is formed between nitrogen and hydrogen, which is a coordinate bond. This is coordinate bond. As nitrogen loses its lone pair, nitrogen bears the positive charge. We get this moiety. Now this dimethyl sulfoxide. We know dimethyl sulfoxide, yes, double bond O is there. As oxygen is more electronegative than sulfur, we can write that the pi bonded electrons are shifted over the oxygen. So oxygen have the negative charge, sulfur have the positive charge. Now this oxide ion, being nucleophilic in nature, it attacks on the carbon. So of course carbon should be deficient for that, for this pi bonded, which is the driving force. Pi bonded electrons are shifted on the nitrogen. Nitrogen gain its lone pair. Carbon is deficient. Positive charge is there on the carbon. So O negative C positive bond formation. Bond formation takes place here. Okay, see this carbon oxygen bond formation is shown. And nitrogen now gain its lone pair. It's okay. In the next step, again this proton now attack on the another nitrogen. In the first step, proton attack on this nitrogen. In the second step, this proton will attack on the another nitrogen. So nitrogen hydrogen bond will form here. Pi bonded, this nitrogen hydrogen bond is formed. At the same time, when these pi bonded electrons are shifted on the nitrogen and nitrogen hydrogen bond is formed, the carbon is deficient. And this bonded pair of electrons between sulfur and oxygen are shifted here. This takes place simultaneously. Formation of this new bond, opening of this bond here, N negative H positive bond formation, and this bond formation, carbon oxygen, takes place simultaneously. This bond is detached and dimethyl sulfide is formed as a byproduct. This is the secondary alcohol, which is our reactant. When this bond is break, at the same time, oxygen donates its lone pair, oxygen of the secondary alcohol or primary alcohol donates its lone pair to the sulfur. The bond is formed between sulfur and oxygen. As oxygen donates its lone pair, what is the charge on oxygen now? Positive, deficient. So here it is miss. So please remember, there is a positive charge as oxygen donates lone pair to the sulfur. Okay, we get this moiety. And this is the byproduct now. Okay, we can say it is the dicyclohexyl derivative of urea, dicyclohexyl urea. Okay, now in the next step, the base is there, triethylamine. That base abstract the proton, there is a formation of carbanion CH2 negative, because this CH3 group is there, this carbon hydrogen bond detachment, carbon bears negative charge, so CH2 negative is there. This proton is loss. Now intramolecular proton transfer, the proton, this hydrogen atom from this carbon migrates to this carbon ion, so C negative and H positive bond is formed. When this new bond is formed, it means the bonded pair of electrons are shifted here, so carbon oxygen bond is formed. In this way we get ketone. As we are using here secondary alcohol, we get the ketone molecule, and this is the byproduct, that is dimethyl sulfide. In this way ketone is, alcohol is converted to ketone. If I take primary alcohol may oxidize to aldehyde. These are the examples of the Spitzer-Moffat oxidation. Secondary alcohol is oxidized to ketone, primary alcohol is oxidized to aldehyde, carbon-carbon double bond does not affected, primary alcohol is oxidized to aldehyde only, primary alcohol is oxidized to aldehyde with this combination of DMSO and DCC, and secondary alcohol is oxidized to ketone. This is about the Fischer-Moffat oxidation. Now the last reagent for the day, DMSO based reagent, is Oppenheimer oxidation. Oppenheimer oxidation is particularly used for the conversion of secondary alcohol to ketone. It is also oxidizing agent. It is the combination of aluminium isopropoxide with DMSO. Sometime instead of DMSO we can take acetone also. So what is Oppenheimer oxidation? We are going to discuss Oppenheimer oxidation. Secondary alcohol is oxidized to ketone in presence of acetone as a solvent, which is the reagent required here, aluminium triisopropoxide. This is the mechanism. It is very simple. This is tri-aluminium isopropoxide, and this is the attack of oxygen on the aluminium. There is a loss of this isopropoxide group, and then this isopropoxide act as a base. There is a removal of this secondary alcohol, and subsequently we get the ketone. Here also secondary alcohol is oxidized to ketone. All these examples show secondary alcohol is oxidized to ketone without affecting carbon-carbon double bond. Carbon-carbon double bond, these carbon-carbon double bonds are not affected, only secondary alcohol is oxidized to ketone. Here also carbon-carbon double bond is not affected, secondary alcohol is oxidized to ketone. Carbon-carbon double bond is not affected, secondary alcohol is converted to ketone. This is all about this DMSO based reagent.